In this video, you'll see how you can configure storage cost optimization in AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery, or AWS DRS. With this capability, you can select optimizations based on performance or cost, choose the appropriate volume types for new and existing servers, and reduce costs associated with your Amazon Elastic Block Store, or EBS, volumes. To get started, let's navigate to AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery. For this demonstration, we've already installed the AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery agent on one of our servers, selected the region for performing disaster recovery, and fully replicated the server. Let's look at the settings. We'll click Edit so we can review the default replication settings in detail. Let's look at the Volumes section. The default EBS volume type setting is also Auto Volume Type Selection. With this setting, DRS dynamically switches between performance-optimized and cost-optimized volume types according to the replicated disk write throughput. The best practice is to retain the default volume type. The two faster general-purpose SSD options utilize faster but more expensive disks. You might choose one of these if your source disk has a high write rate, you want faster performance in general, or you want to speed up the initial sync process. The lower-cost, throughput-optimized HDD option utilizes slower, less expensive disks. This is a good choice if you want to keep costs low, your large disks do not have frequent changes, or you're not concerned with a long initial sync process. The EBS volume type affects only disks greater than 125 GB. By default, smaller disks use magnetic HDD volumes. Any changes made to the default settings apply only to new servers you set up to replicate. Next, let's go back and see how to make changes to an existing replicated server. We'll work with the first server in the list, which has been replicated and is ready for recovery. Let's review the disk settings. This server has two volumes. Both are assigned the default auto volume type selection. In parentheses are the volume types that DRS assigned for optimization. Let's reconfigure the 520 gigabyte disk. Let's change the staging disk type to Throughput Optimized HDD ST1. Now let's go to Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud, or Amazon EC2, to confirm that the volume change was made to the server. We'll review our volumes resources. Let's sort the volumes by size from highest to lowest to find the one we just revised. Here's the volume we adjusted. It still shows as being the GP3 type. Let's refresh the data. It can take some time for the change to become apparent. Now we can see the volume type has been changed to ST1. The old GP3 volume, appearing just above the new one in the list, will be deleted automatically once all the blocks have finished creating. Let's refresh again. Now the GP3 volume is gone, with only the ST1 volume remaining. You've just seen how you can configure storage cost optimization in AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.